Subscribe to Agile Neuro and hit the bell icon for latest updates. Hello everyone, my name is Amarendra Chitale and I am a cognitive wellness interventionist. Well, today's topic is also very interesting. Today's topic talks of three areas of your life: relationships, parenting, and leadership. I'm sure you know this, that at different times in the day, you are playing a different role. Like, for example, if you're at home, then you are, let's say, a husband or wife or a child. I may not be a child, but, you know, or you could be a parent. You could be an uncle or an aunt. That's all inside the house. When you're at work, you could be reporting to someone, or 10 people might be reporting to you, which means you are a leader, isn't it? In the evening, you might be going out with your boyfriend, girlfriend, with your spouse, and then that's a different role altogether. Why I told you about these roles is because these are the three areas that we'll be talking of: relationships, parenting, and leadership. Do you know what is the most important ingredient in all these three areas that I just spoke of? The most important ingredient in these three areas is trust. Think about it. If you don't trust your leader, are you going to listen to your leader? You wouldn't get into a relationship with that person if you don't find that person trustworthy. And in parenting, I've seen so many times, so many parents saying this, that, you know, the child has stopped listening to them, especially when they reach the age of, you know, between 12 to 15 or, you know, 15 and above, where suddenly kids become rebels. I've seen this so many times. Now, what happens is there is this trust deficit somewhere, and I'd really like to put some light on it. What I'll be doing is I'll be telling you a story now, and then I'll tell you how trust builds itself up, and then you'll have a good roadmap of how trustworthy you can become. You can use the same structure in any area of life, by the way, and I'll be giving you these examples. Like, for example, here's an interesting question. Have you tried smoking anytime? Some of you might be smokers. Some of you may have tried smoking, you know, just for the curiosity part of it. I know some people who have tried smoking because they've said that, you know, I don't want to be lying on my deathbed thinking that, you know, I've not tried anything or I've not tried smoking. I've seen such people. Like, I've tried smoking, okay? I don't smoke, but I've tried smoking. And if you ask anybody who has tried smoking, we'll get the same answer. That, yeah, friends were there, okay? They were smoking, I was there. I had that curiosity, I mean, why do these people smoke? And then suddenly some person, some friend offered a cigarette, and then these people take the cigarette and, you know, they start smoking. Now, obviously, you take the first drag, you start coughing, right? Now, here's the thing. Like, if I'm a stranger to you, and if I come to you and offer you a cigarette, you are not going to accept that cigarette from me. Why? Because I'm a stranger. There's no trust between us. So let me just link this story with trust. So here's a question. How do you choose your friends? Well, the answer is actually you don't choose your friends. Friendship happens. Dosti ho jati hai. Pyar ho jata hai. It's that kind of a stuff. That's kind of a thing. You know, what happens is it's the wavelength that matches. And unconsciously, you start connecting with the person. By the way, in all our minds, we have this definition of appropriateness and inappropriateness, right? We know who is appropriate for us and who is inappropriate for us. Now, that's a subjective definition for all of us. Like, for example, what is appropriate for you may not be appropriate for me, okay? And the friends that you have, I'm sure you'll say that they are good friends. They are appropriate people for you. They're good morally, ethically, they're all good. That's the first thing that is required in trust: your credibility in the eyes of other people. Yeah, we call that ethos. And when you say friends, there's an emotional connect, there's a rapport. You'll realize that all your friends are kind of similar to you. People like each other when they are like each other. And there's a full form of rapport over here. Really, all people prefer others resemble themselves. Do you know that we want all the people around us, we want our kind of people around us. But, you know, usually that's not the case. So, first part is the credibility. The people who were smoking there, they were your friends and they are credible people in your eyes. morally, ethically, everything is good. Second is obviously the rapport is there, that emotional connect is there, and that rapport or emotional connect is called pathos. And then because the wavelength matches, you know, their logic and your logic matches, hence you are able to connect with it. You know, I had this friend who said one day to me that, I'm sure you know this movie, Irv Wednesday. Nasiruddin Shah and Anupam Kher are there in this movie. Fantastic movie. If you've not seen it, you should watch it. And she said to me that, you know, that's the most boring movie she's ever seen. I instantly, you know, I thought I should not be friends with this person, you know, because her logic about movies and my logic about movies doesn't match at all. So logic. Have you ever asked any of these smokers, you know, why they smoke? Sometimes they'll say that, you know, there's a lot of pressure in life and, you know, when I take that drag, I feel extremely happy. Or, you know, the stress is gone. So it's pressure, and then smoking actually relieves that pressure. Or in the morning, they don't get pressure. Okay. And then they smoke and, you know, instantly everything happens. So there are these three things now. Ethos, which is your credibility as a person in the eyes of other people. Pathos is your emotional connect with other people. And logos is the logic with which you live your life. Even in communication, are you structuring everything logically? Okay. So that other people understand. Now, these three things are important in trust. You realize that if any of these three things, if they are not there, just remove one part of it, and you realize that there is trust deficit. Remove credibility. The person in front of you is not a credible person. You are not going to trust that person. If that emotional connect is not there, obviously you are not going to consider that person as your friend. Hence, there's no trust over there. And then logic. You know, in leadership, a lot of leaders do not have that connect with their people because they're talking illogical things. Somebody comes with a problem, and then a leader is supposed to give a solution, which, by the way, leaders are not supposed to give solutions, ready-made solutions. They should be pushing the people in the right direction so that they find solutions for themselves, right? So, but that push should be a logical push. It should be in an area which logically makes sense. Even in parenting, for example, when you ask your child to do something, the child is going to ask why. You should always back it up with three things. Okay, the child may connect with all the three things or one of those three things, and hence will find value in doing whatever you're telling that child to do. So that's the strength of trust, or rather logos. So trust happens because of ethos, pathos and logos. This is a Greek concept. It's 2500 years old, and I'm sure a lot of this is written in Bhagavad Gita and Vedas and all these books which are there. So if you want to be a trustworthy person, make sure that these three things are there in your life. Think about a leader at your workplace. He's telling you that you have to be loyal to this company, stay with this company, and his own resume is on one job portal. He's not walking the talk, is he? So his integrity is not there. And intent, what is intent? Niyat, as they call it in Hindi. You know, if I have a problem with some person, I should be dealing with that person only. If I start asking his colleagues, you know, what's wrong with this person? Now, suddenly, if these people go and tell that guy that, you know, your boss was asking us about you, what is that person going to think? He's going to think, what is the intention of my boss? Why is he bitching about me? You'll realize that if the intent goes bad, the character goes bad. Character goes bad, credibility goes bad. If credibility goes bad, that's the ethos part, trust goes bad. The same thing with integrity. The same thing with competence and results. If you don't show the right results, suddenly there is deficit in credibility. Parenting. So if you don't walk the talk, then your kids are not going to show you that kind of respect because there is lack of credibility. Again, in the relationships, for that matter. I mean, some of you are married. You'll realize that you, after listening to all this, you'll realize that you are still in your marriage because these three things still exist in your marriage. The ethos part, you consider your partner to be credible in whatever ways. Then that emotional connect is there, and then that, and you follow the same logic when you're at home or when you're outside, when you're amongst people together. And that's, if any of this actually was to go bad, okay, let's say you suddenly have an extramarital affair, your credibility is at stake, isn't it? That's how marriages break, really. Because the credibility goes, then the emotional connect goes, and then when you start fighting, suddenly both of you are talking illogical things from each other's model of the world perspective. Okay, so remember, guys, if you in any area of your life, if you want other people to trust you, you need to have these three things: ethos, pathos, and logos. Credibility, emotional connect, and logic. Okay, I hope you like this video in the cognitive wellness series. Feel free to comment, feel free to connect with me. The details, my contact details are given. The website is there, www.agileneuro.com. Please visit our website, and again, please comment, share, and if you need to talk to me anytime, just pick up the phone, call me. Okay? Thank you very much. Have a great day.